Welcome to LifeSci TV. I'm Greg Greenberg reporting from New York City. And today I'm here with Professor Dror Harats. He's the CEO of VBL Therapeutics. Welcome, Professor Harats.
Thank you.
Well, VBL Therapeutics is working on a treatment for brain cancer, and your lead drug, VB111, is in late-stage clinical trials. But before we talk about VB111, tell me a little bit more about VBL Therapeutics and your background.
So VBL Therapeutics is a late-stage biopharmaceutical company discovering and developing novel first-in-class drugs for cancer. I'm a physician and a scientist. I'm the founder, inventor, and the CEO of the company. Our lead compound is VB111, which is a gene therapy-based anti-cancer therapy. We are developing it for GBM, or glioblastoma multiforme, which is the most common brain tumor and the most aggressive brain tumor. Beside of that, we already know that the drug is actually working quite well in many different solid tumors. We know that from our phase one clinical trial, where we could show in patients with different tumors that they have benefit of overall survival, and from two different other phase two trials that we ran, one in late stage ovarian cancer, what we call platinum resistant ovarian cancer, and late stage thyroid cancer.
Can you talk a little bit more about GBM and what makes it such a devastating form of brain cancer?
So GBM is actually a rare disease. It's about 10 to 12,000 patients a year in the United States, but we all know patients with GBM because it happens in middle age, prime time of your life, and it's actually a very devastating disease. From the time of diagnosis to the time of death is about only 15 months. And from the time of diagnosis, patients get surgery, radiation therapy and chemotherapy, and nevertheless, within 6 months, half of them will have a recurrent of the disease, and most of them eventually have a recurrent of the disease and they will die. For recurrent GBM, we don't have any drugs that ever showed increase in overall survival. So patients get radiation again, surgery again, they get chemotherapy again, they get Avastin, but nothing has shown actually increase in overall survival. So to have a drug that will show increase in overall survival, that's a breakthrough.
And how does VB111 treat GBM? Talk about how it's administered.
So VB111 is actually a gene therapy-based treatment, but it's a very simple administrative drug. It's like many other anti-cancer drugs. It's given as a simple IV infusion every 8 weeks for about half an hour. So the patient is actually coming to the clinic, get this therapy, and in an hour later, he can go back home for another 8 weeks. It's simple for the patient, it's simple for the doctor, but the drug is very sophisticated and work basically in a very nice dual mechanism on the tumor.
Can you explain a little bit more about the dual mechanism with regard to VB111?
So, actually, when you talk about anti-cancer therapy, one of the ways to go is to go after the cancer cells. But cancer cells mutated very quickly, and actually it's very difficult to hunt all of them. But what we are doing is actually working on the milieu, on the tumor itself. And we're working in two different ways. We are not enabling the tumor to keep on growing by attacking its ability to build new blood vessels. The tumor needs the blood supply. And the other mechanism is making the immune system recognize a tumor and fighting it. So it works in a different way than what we know about the checkpoint inhibitors, but it should work very well in combination with all of these modalities. We believe that it will be part of the novel modern immune oncology drugs.
Can you give me a little bit more of a sense of the timeline for VB111 as to the clinical trials?
So we ended up a phase two clinical trial in GBM where we showed that basically we are doubling overall survival. We took the most severe cases as we do see in real life. We took patients that had more than one tumor. We took patients that couldn't get operated. Nevertheless, we could show increase in survival, doubling it from 8 months to 15 months. We are running now the GLOBE trial, which is our single needed phase three trial done under an SPA with the FDA. We have a fast track and of course an orphan designation. And we expect the top line data in the beginning of 2018.
And are you working with any partners on these trials?
We're working with UCLA, UCSF, MD Anderson, with Dana-Farber in Boston, with Mass General, and many other major centers in the United States. And I believe one of the reasons that a lot of them wants to work with us because this is a cutting-edge technology, very novel anti-cancer gene therapy.
Were there any other benefits you found coming out of the phase one and the phase two trials for VB111?
Actually, yes, we do see long-term survivors. When one look at clinical trials, one of the things that we want to see is a median how long the patient are alive and to see that we prolong it. But on the other hand, we want to see if there is a certain percentage of patients that actually enjoy it for a very long time, what we call long survivors. And both in our phase one trial, in all three phase two trials, we could see certain amount of patients. In some clinical trials, it came all the way up to 40% of the patients that lived much longer. In the phase one, we can have the benefit to follow the patient for a longer period of time, so we could see a patient that are still alive after 5 years. And we are talking about patients that came into the trial when they lost hope and didn't respond to any other drug. So we do see a very long survivor benefit with this drug.
That's great to hear. And looking even further ahead, if and when you do get good news regarding to that phase three trial, when do you think you can get VB111 to market?
I think that VB111 can get to market sometimes in 2019. And if things go well, it can be on the market for other indication. The first one is going to be ovarian cancer in 2020 or the beginning of 21.
So Professor Harats, we've been speaking a lot about VB111. What else does VBL Therapeutics have in the pipeline?
So VBL actually have three different platform technologies. The first one is actually what led to VB111. It's a vascular targeting system technologies that enable us to actually target the blood vessels of the tumors. The second one is a novel small molecule family that we discovered named the lesinoxoids, which are anti-inflammatory compounds. We already have proof of concept in phase two trial in vascular inflammation, and we are aiming to develop it for NASH, or non-alcoholic steatohepatitis. Recently, we discovered the novel protein on the membrane of cells, which can be another very interesting target for cancer therapy.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.